Do the deals in your CRM go through different stages depending on what type of deal that they are? Hi, my name is Zach Spader with Cornerstone Solutions, and today I'm going to show you how to build out different deal stage pipelines within Zoho CRM. Let's take a look. Okay, so the first thing that I want to do now that I'm logged into my demo CRM here is click on Setup. And first, I'm going to go to my deals and look at the stages that I currently have. So I'm going to go to Customization, Modules, and Fields. We're going to hover over Deals, and we're going to choose Stage Probability Mapping. And this is going to show me the stages that are currently in my deal process here. Lots of different use cases for why you might want to use pipelines. You may have different products that require different stages in the process. You may also have different types of customers, maybe a new customer versus an existing customer. That's the use case that we're going to use today, new versus existing customers. And in our use case, we're going to say that the existing customers, we don't need to have a contract sent because we already have a contract in place. So if they're new, we want to get the contract sent so that we can have them sign that. Once we have that signed, we don't need to do that on any subsequent deals. So this is the stage that I'm going to use to differentiate between our different pipelines, whether it's a new or an old customer. I'm going to exit out of here. I'm going to go back into the setup menu, and I'm going to click on the pipelines under customization. And the first time you set this up, it will show you the screen right here. You'll click create new pipeline, and we'll give it a name. New customer pipeline. And then we want to add stages to this pipeline. And so in the new customer pipeline, we want it to go through all the different stages. So we're going to click all the different stages that are here. We've got those all added. And then we'll make this the default pipeline. We'll say that this one's going to be default. And we'll go ahead and click save. Okay. And you can see when we did that, it created two actually. It created our new customer pipeline and it created a standard, and they're exactly the same. But I'm just going to delete this one out of here since we don't really need that, since our standard is going to be the new customer pipeline. Okay. So now our default is the new customer pipeline. And I want to create a new one for the existing customer. So I'm going to click create new pipeline again. And I'll call this one existing customer pipeline. And on this one, again, we're going to do all the stages, except we're not going to do the contract sent stage. So we're going to select all these different stages, leaving out the contract sent. And then we'll save that. And now you can see we have a separate pipeline for the existing customers that skips over the contract sent stage. So then in the deal module, what this would actually look like, we can click into an existing deal here. And you can see on this deal record now, we have a pipeline field here. And all the deals, when you set this up, are going to get defaulted to the whatever you set as the default pipeline here. And so that's the new customer pipeline. And so you can see in the new customer pipeline, we have all the stages here, including contract sent. But if I were to go in here and edit this record and select the existing customer pipeline and then save this, you can see that that contract sent no longer appears in the deal stages here. So that's the use case of this, is that you know, for whatever reason, you have a different sales process for different types of customers or different types of products, things like that, that you need to be able to track. You need to be able to create a customized pipeline of stages for that particular type of record. Now, I'm going to go back for a second here, and I'm going to talk about some use cases of why you might do this instead of using a different layout. So as you know, you can create a separate layout for any of the modules in CRM, including the deal module. You could have a separate set of stages in a different layout. With different layouts, you can assign a whole different set of stages. There are some reasons why you might want to do that. If the deals that you're doing are vastly different and require different information and different fields that you're tracking, and maybe a completely different set of stages that are nowhere near what your stages are in your regular layout, you may want to create a separate layout and separate stages for that. The pipeline feature is for clients who have a very similar deal process, but maybe one type of deal just skips a step or two in the process. And so they're not vastly different. They're just a little bit different. Maybe you have to collect all the same information on the deal record. You don't want to have different fields or anything like that. You just want to be able to edit or pick and choose a few of your stages that need to be added or removed for a particular pipeline. So that's really the case for why you would use a pipeline instead of using a whole separate layout for your deals to track that. I hope this video has been helpful. Thanks and have a great day.
If you found this video helpful, be sure to like it and leave us a comment. You can also subscribe to our channel and click the bell next to the subscribe button to be notified of new videos. If you want to learn more about Zoho or would like help with anything Zoho related, head on over to our website at zcrmhelp.com to connect with us. Thanks for watching.